Hey guys, it's Chelsea, and today I wanted to talk about my 30-day hiatus from Twitter. They only love me till I'm gone. They only hear me if I say the right. Okay, so I decided to take a break from Twitter because when everything kind of went towards the Black Lives Matter, heavy on that, I had to leave Twitter because there was just so many hateful things that were on my feed. There was just political bias on my feed, and then also I felt like my posts weren't getting any acknowledgement anymore, and I realized that Twitter was not the same. And then I just decided I'm leaving Twitter for 30 days to see how it goes and see if I can make it without feeling like I have to go back on it or whatever. And I let my followers know, I let my friends know that I was taking a break. But now that 30 days has gone by, I do not feel like I want to return to Twitter because I realized that I had more time on my hands not being on Twitter. I didn't really miss people on Twitter outside of the people that I usually talk to on there. And my mental health was way better than it's been in a while. And then also, the thing about Twitter is that's my profile that, is public, and anybody can look it up at any time. So it's, I don't even feel like it's secure anymore. And so my posts weren't getting the engagement that they used to get. And when I joined Twitter, it was a great place. I really connected lot of people there, and then people would follow you, they'd actually talk to you, and you'd get to know them, and then you would, you were aware of who was your followers. Now, it's at the point where people just follow you, and then they don't talk to you. They acknowledge a couple of your tweets, and then if they don't like something you tweet, especially if it's, not agreeing with something that they believe in or their political or religious views or whatever, they just unfollow you. And some people even block you. And then there's been always that issue with the creepy guys that show up in your DMs, and it's just creepy because you don't even know who they are, and then they have this profile picture, but is that even who they are? And then there's just a lack of engagement. I literally, towards the end of when I was on Twitter, especially in National Poetry Month, I literally had to message my core group of friends on there and be like, okay, here, I sent out this tweet today, if you guys can just, acknowledge it, then, maybe it'll show up in the regular feed. And then I did notice that my engagement was higher. And then I even tried doing Twitter ads to get more, my tweet noticed, because, I had a bunch of poetry that I put out, and I wanted it to be noticed. And the Twitter ads, that was a horrible experience, and it was a waste of $39 for them to not even, for my tweet not even to get a lot of retweets or likes. It literally just, I don't even know. It said that it got a bunch of impressions and engagements, but it's obviously not, because nobody went to my site from it. And nobody retweeted it or liked it. And that's the only reason I ran the Twitter ad. But I mean, now that I know that I'm not going to really be using Twitter, I am still going to leave it up because Twitter really showed me a lot about social media. And then there was many things that happened on Twitter that were, like, big for me. Like, I actually was the reason that professional skateboarder Ryan Chuckler got a Twitter, because I told him about it. I'm sure he had other people also on his team that probably told him about it, too. But I'm saying, like, I feel like I was the main reason, because back then I was a big fan of him, and, when it first came out in 2009, and I would write him letters that I would send to him to his private mailing address, and he got them, and then he joined Twitter, and then after that, I was the first fan that he acknowledged on Twitter, and he didn't just acknowledge me, like, he actually shouted me out in a tweet because he didn't know how to reply to a tweet yet, and then so my name literally was, like, on his profile. And, those were big moments. And then he replied to a couple of other tweets. He also, made me custom Etnies because of a reply to a tweet of his that I sent. But, and then there's, like, I've gotten replies back from many other, like, musicians and people, skateboarders, what have you, and that was, like, exciting for me. And then the biggest thing for me was when I was followed by Hot Chill Ray, which is my favorite band, and I also always get acknowledged by them, like, they always either like or reply to my tweets, and they even knew that it was me when recently I called into the national radio station where they were, I think it's like Love It or Leave It was what it was called, and I called in for them, and then I got on the radio, and they knew that it was me, so that was cool. But outside of that, I don't think I'm coming back to Twitter, and so this video is basically sharing that with everyone. I mean, I'll keep my Twitter because I don't know if I'll, whenever I put a book out, if I'll need Twitter for that purpose, but right now I think it's okay if I leave Twitter and not be on it because it just feels like it's biased, and I don't mean anything against anyone that follows that viewpoint, but I don't think that my feed has to be consistently full of tweets about one narrative when I follow many people from many different viewpoints, many different areas of the world, and I want to see everybody's tweets. I don't want to just see one view and for it to be filling my feed so bad that, like, I feel like they're yelling in my face. So, that's how I felt when I left Twitter, and I will be going on to check it, but I'm not gonna come back to it. This is gonna be my announcement. Basically, I'm not going back to Twitter until I feel like it's necessary, and I feel like I can come back to Twitter, because I don't feel like I need it right now. Okay. Thanks for watching, guys. Until next time, feel free to express it yourself.